from the heart. It was all from the heart. Everything was real. Yeah. Dwelling in the past, flashbacks when I was young. Whoever thought I'd have a baby girl and three sons? But going through this difficult stage, I found it hard to believe. While my whole earth had so many seeds, but she's a whole woman. And due to me, I respect that. I saw life for what it's really worth and took a step back. Family ain't family no more. We used to play ball, eggs after school, eat grits, cause we was poor. Grab the pliers, bought a channel, fixed the hanger on the TV. Rocking each other's pants to school wasn't easy, we survived winters. Snotty nose with no coats. We kept it real, but the older brother still had jokes. Sadly, daddy left me at the age of 6. I didn't know nothing, but mommy neatly packed the shit. She cried, and grandma held the family down. I guess mommy wasn't strong enough, she just went down. Check it, 15 of us in a 3-bedroom apartment, roaches everywhere. Cousins and aunts was there, 4 on the bed, 2 at the foot, 2 at the head. I didn't like to sleep with John, Johnny peed the bed, 7 o'clock, fucking roaches out the cereal box. Some shared the same spoon, watch a Saturday. Cartoon, sugar water was a thing. Every meal was no frill. In the summer, feed lunch held us down like steel. And it was days I had to go to Texas with a note. Stay in Gloria, can I borrow some food? I'm dead broke. So embarrassing, I couldn't stand a knock in they door. My friends might be laughing, I spent stamps in stores. Mommy wears a toilet paper, use the newspaper. Look, Miss Rose gave us a couch. She's the name of things was deep. My whole youth was sharper than cleats. Two brothers with muscular dystrophy. Kill me, but I remember this. Mom's a lick of fingertips to wipe the cold out my eye before school with a spit. Case worker had her running back to face. I caught a case house and try to throw us out of our place. Sometimes I look up at the stars and analyze the sky and ask myself, was I meant to be here? Why? Mommy, I love you.
And I'm so thankful to be through. All that I got is you.
It's all you.
And I'm so thankful
to be through.
Exist in my space like man, woman, and child. What reality and reality gonna keep it real with us? I remember them good old days. You can see, that's the child I was, what made me the man I am today. See, because if you forget where you come from, you're never gonna make it where you're going. Because you lost the reality of yourself. So take one stroll through your mind and see what you will find. And you'll see your whole universe all over again and again and again and again and again. Yeah.
What's up, everybody? How you guys doing, man?
Oh yeah, baby.
How you guys doing? Good evening, everyone. It's really not a good evening, honestly. It's an up and down, emotional, unbelievable day, man. For all of us, I'm sure you guys already all know, man, of the passing of David. And he's with Street Beast Media. My thoughts and prayers and everything goes out to his family, man. His daughter, his wife. I'm so sorry for you guys' loss, man. I can't imagine what you guys are going through right now. And it's, I don't, like, the whole day, man, I just been in disbelief, man, myself. And it's been one of those days, man, that I haven't had in a long time. I haven't had it in a long time, man. But I just want to say, man, David, you're going to be missed, man. You will be missed, and you're a great person, man. Great soul. You love to talk, man. You're something else, man. Yeah, for also too, in case a lot of people are wondering, like, what's going on, who's David? David was a fellow streamer. He was a fellow streamer. I met him through my live stream. He commented on my stream for a long time, man. He would always comment. He was a good support. He was a supporter. And he watched the live stream. He watched the live stream for a while, for I want to say a good 2 years that I remember him watching the stream. And he was always commenting. He commented under the name on Facebook, David Sparling. And then on the YouTube side, it was, I want to say Street Beast on the YouTube side, right? And he changed the name. He kept changing the name on the YouTube side a couple times. So yeah, man, he passed away today, this morning. I guess like around 5 a.m. of complications to COVID. And Super Beast. Wendy, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Super Beast. So yeah, he commented on the stream and he followed me for a long time. He was a supporter. He still shows as a supporter on my page. And he ended up going on a couple ride-alongs with me, and then ventured off and started his own page because he's seen, you know, how cool the hobby was of doing this, and he got his own page. He started up a couple months ago, and then his last live stream was on September 9th, and then he contracted that COVID and passed away today, man. It's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. It's all fucked up, man. Yeah. Tonight's gonna be one of those nights, man, where you know, I want to stay positive. I want to stay positive, you know, and just keep rolling, man. I honestly didn't even want to come out. I was talking with another supporter of mine, and I was telling her, like, she's a close supporter. She pretty much hits me up all the time, every other day. You guys know her in the chat is Breeze, Sabrina. And I was telling her, like, you know, I didn't even know if I want to go live, man. I kind of want to take a break, but I know there's a lot of you guys out there that had questions and, you know, are going through it as well, man. And you guys are going through it as well. And I felt like, you know, maybe me going live would kind of help with the process, man. And and we could talk about it and share great memories or conversations that you guys had in the chat, and just kind of, you know, try to make the best out of this horrible situation that's going on right now. So that's why I decided to go live. I was like, you know what, let's go live, man. Let's keep it rolling. So yeah, so got it. Yep. Monica, Cheryl, Wendy, Chris, Mitch. How you guys doing? Sadie, Deneen, hello. May, Larry, Monica, DFL, Scene, 672006, Chris. There's another name. Marie, Brian Man. I think I said that one. How you guys doing, man? Hope you guys are having a wonderful and safe day out there. So yeah, let's go move around. We're gonna move around, guys. He made my night, such a funny guy. He didn't hold back. Sad day. Yeah, he was a great guy, man. He loved to chat, man. Oh, Robert, sorry to hear that, man. Yeah, I can't. I'm just, I hit him up around 3 a.m., right? Because I was up these last few days, dude. He's just been in my mind the whole time. And I was constantly checking in on him. And I text him, and he said, not doing good at all. And I text him yesterday, I think it was yesterday, it said, not doing good at all. And I said, dude, don't tell me that, what the fuck? And that was pretty much it. I didn't get a reply back. And he did reply back. He said this, let me go back. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so I said on Thursday the 16th. Yesterday, I said, dude, what the fuck? You good? He put no. I put, don't tell me that. And I replied, don't tell me that. He replied back, I will be fine down the road, just fucked up for now. And I think I was live and I didn't reply back, because this was yesterday at 10:50 p.m. And then at 10:50 p.m. I put yo, and then no reply. And then at 12:03 a.m. I put yo, you better, still no reply. Yesterday, this was 12:03 a.m. last night. And then on the messenger side, I put a, so at no reply, and then at 3:01 a.m., I messaged them. I said, wake your ass up. And I said, wake your ass up at 3:01 just to see if he was going to reply. Because I'm like, dude, I'm the type of person to be like, if I'm worried about somebody and I'm like, I'll just continue bugging them. And then even if he would be like, dude, fuck you, leave me alone or some shit, then I'd be like, all right, good. All right, cool. He's good. So, but still no response, man. And I guess around 5 a.m. this morning is when everything went down. So, it's fucked up, man. I didn't... It's crazy, man. 1 minute here, 1 minute you're here, the next minute you're gone, man. Yeah, yeah. And his last live stream was on the 9th, right? That's the only one I found. That's the only one I found, man. The times that we were in, he was just getting started too, man. He was just getting started in this whole hobby thing of wanting a live stream. He just recently got his tripod, his camera. I was supposed to sell him a camera. I ended up liking the camera so much that I said, bro, I'm not gonna sell it, I'm gonna keep it. I just feel fucking horrible now, man, because I should have sold it to him. I should have hooked him up with it. And so anyways, he got a camera and he ended the stream like around 11 o'clock, almost midnight. And I told him it would be like 1 o'clock in the morning and he couldn't figure something out with the camera and the hooking up the phone. I'd be like, I'll text him the address and be like, bro, come to my house. We'd be outside. We went outside at 1 o'clock. We met up like three times at my house. I know him a lot through the chat and through the stream and then seeing him out and about. And so we were just starting to get to know each other, man. And then this whole COVID stuff. So we couldn't really do ride-alongs much because of the whole COVID thing. And it sucks, man. It sucks to see him go out from this virus, man. But yeah, what my point is, that he had so much in front of him. He had so much in front of him of what he wanted to do and just everything, man. He had a big vision, man, of what he wanted to do. And sucks, man. Yeah, yeah, Debbie, he would say I was his mentor, and I told him, I said, bro, don't say that. I would say, bro, don't say that. I'm not your mentor. That sounds corny, dude. Like, I wasn't used to that, you know, and he'd just laugh about it. He'd laugh about it, dude, and he already expected I was going to say some stupid shit like that, because that's me, you know. I'm quick to say some stupid shit, and... It's like and be like, fuck, I should have never said that. My bad, you know what I mean? I guess it sounded worse than what I thought it was gonna sound like, but he just laughed about it and was like, all right, cool, like, I don't know, man, but he's gonna be missed, man, a lot. I can't. You guys just keep his family, keep his family in prayers, man. Keep his daughter in prayers. Keep his wife in prayers. Keep them in prayers. They need a lot of prayers right now, man. A lot of prayers. I know they did a GoFundMe, and I want to share the GoFundMe right now since we're talking about this and stuff. Let me go grab the GoFundMe, and I'm going to drop the link right here in the chat. And LAOC TV, man, thank you, brother. Appreciate the 10 bucks. And appreciate the comment, man. So, yeah, man, Angela, that's how we all feel, man. That's how we all feel right now. And that's how we all feel, man. We're just in disbelief and shocked. We can't believe it, man. At Monica's comment, yeah, dude. Hold on, guys. Let me see. I want to drop his GoFundMe real fast. If you guys can. If not, you know. And like the family was saying, you know, $3, $2, $5, $10. No amount is too small, man. Especially in the times like this. So I know they posted, they shared the GoFundMe, so obviously they can use the extra cash or the extra help. So let me see, let me grab this real fast. And yep. It was just like a quick little moment of silence thing, dude. Quick little moment of silence, man, for the passing of David Sparling. All right, let's roll. Where are we gonna go, man? Let's go find a car or something, right? Let's go find a car, man.
Fine.
Yeah, guys, I, like I said, man, I wanted to come on and acknowledge the fact of another fellow streamer passing away and everything. And, you know, it's been a while since I lost somebody that was close, man. And, you know, this one really hit home. I felt like I know the guy personally. And, yeah, man, we had a lot of great conversations, man, and, you know, I just want to come on and acknowledge that fact, have all you guys come on and comment, put your love and support in the comments. I dropped the GoFundMe link, I pinned it right here in the comments. If you guys want to, you know, continue with the love and comments, man, this is going to be something to look back on for all of you guys, with all the other memories that David posted on his page, and, I'm gonna take a little quick break and come back on here shortly. And I wanna save this live stream down. You guys drop your comments, man. This is live right now. 9:17, 9:47 p.m. In memory of David Sparling, man. Like I said, much love and my prayers and thoughts go out to his family, his daughter, his wife, his kids. And I hope this all eventually becomes, you know, a little easy to deal with. I know how hard and difficult it is to lose a loved one. And hopefully, man, you guys could find peace and comfort in this terrible situation. So, much love to all of you guys out there. You guys be safe. Take care. Catch you guys on the next one. I'm gonna take a little quick break. I'll be right back.